The Eagle's Daughter by Judith Tarr. Prologue. Aachen, Christmas, 983. It was a splendid day to crown a king. Cold but diamond clear, snow like a glittering mantle over the roofs and walls of Aachen, the sun offering what warmth it might in the shadow of the solstice. The people who filled the city to bursting, hardy Germans all, stood bareheaded and even bare-armed under the blue vault of heaven, and sent up their roar of approbation, acclaiming their new lord, Otto, son of Otto, son of Otto of the Saxons. Under the vault of Aachen's chapel, under the eye of Christ the King, Otto, who was about to be king, moved slowly through the rite of his consecration. He was extraordinarily patient, Aspasia thought, craning to see past the lordly figures of the bishops and their scarcely less lordly acolytes. Small as she was among all these great hulking barbarians, she was never as small as the King of the Germans, the heir of the Holy Roman Empire, the august and illustrious prince, the seal of the peace between the Germans and their too often distant overlord. Otto the King, son of Otto the Emperor, was well grown for his age, and while Aspasia had anything to do with it, most well trained. But he was only 3 years old. He had objected once to forsaking the bright free air for the musty darkness of the chapel. There was very nearly an incident. A tantrum, Aspasia would call it. But she had seen it coming, and she had caught his eye even as he opened his mouth to howl. He was a wise child. He scowled, but he let himself be led away from her into that glittering place which Charlemagne had built. He did not sulk for long. He loved the music and the sheen of a thousand candles on floor of marble and walls of porphyry and roof of mosaic as magnificent as any in Byzantium, and the shift and shimmer of gems and silks and furs on the backs and arms and heads of all the great lords of Germany. His own lords, though he was too young still to understand what that meant. His father was emperor of both Germany and Italy, and had perforce to give half his mind and most of his presence to his realm south of the Alps. The younger Otto was his hope and promise in the north, his proof that Germany was not forgotten. The empire had an heir, and that heir was Germany's king. It was wise and politic. Germany's king was a child with his father's red, fair Saxon hair and his mother's great dark eyes, stiff almost to immobility in robes of imperial silk. A child invested with a sword a handspan taller than himself and armlets vast enough to swallow both his arms in one, and a cloak which enveloped all of him but his small, pale face, and scepter and staff cut to the measure of a man and a king. A man would bear them all at once. This child was given them one by one, then each was taken away. Otto was much too small a prince for the regalia of a king, but one mark of his rank at least was made to his measure, the golden circlet of the diadem. The bishops anointed his brows with oil from Jerusalem and bound them with the diadem. He did not fret with it, as Aspasia had half feared he would. He bore it easily, as a king should. Aspasia's eye moved past him. The empress stood where these lords and prelates had made her stand, in the upper sanctuary behind the throne, almost out of sight of the people below. Almost, but not quite. She looked, with her daughters about her, like an image of Hagia Sophia in Byzantium where she was born, the moon and her attendant planets lofty and imperially beautiful. No one would ever have guessed that she was angry. The Germans thought themselves subtle in setting her so high and yet so far apart, remote and powerless. Theophano would teach them what subtlety was. Aspasia, having surrendered her charge to the lords and the bishops, managed to come no closer to the throne than the chapel directly below it. They had used the throne in the portico that was proper to the German kings. It was that to which Otto had been raised for his election and acclamation.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.